When setting up a project in Monolix, the distribution of the individual parameters can be selected from a list which contains normal, log normal, logit, and probit distributions. These four distributions have been described in the feature of the week video number 31, and they capture most of the situations. But it may happen that more complex distributions are needed. In this video, I will cover two examples. First, a logit normal distribution bounded between two values different from 0 and 1, and a distribution that combines a log normal distribution with a Boxcox transformation of the random effect. Let's start with a bounded distribution using a simple model for the circadian rhythms of testosterone as an example. The testosterone levels are assumed to have a base level described by the base parameter here, and on top of it an oscillation described by the cosine function with a period of 24 hours. AMP is the amplitude of the oscillations, and phase is a parameter that represents the time of the peak. For all individuals, its value should be between 0 and 24, so I will assume a logit distribution between 0 and 24. To do that, I will use the logit between 0 and 1 from the interface and then do a transformation in the model such that the parameter can span from 0 to 24. So let's have a look in practice. In the model file, I have defined in the input line a parameter phase 0, 1. This parameter has a logit normal distribution here, so it means that it can take values between 0 and 1. And in the model file, I don't use this parameter directly. Instead, I describe phase 0, 24, that is phase 0, 1 multiplied by 24. So phase 0, 24 will span from 0 to 24, and this parameter is then used in the expression. The model parameter that is estimated by Monolix in the results is phase 0, 1. So if I want to know the value of phase 0, 24 for each individual, I have to write the stable statement here such that this value will be outputted in the files. So the general recipe to define a parameter distribution bounded between two values A and B is the following. In the structured model file, in the model input list, I defined the parameter 0, 1. Then I defined in the core of the code the parameter of interest via this transformation, and then I need to write this parameter in the table statement such that it is outputted by Monolix. And in the statistical model and task tab, I need to set a logit distribution for param 01. So that's it for the first example. Now let's focus on the second example. For this example, I have used the tobramycin dataset from our online tobramycin case study. The dataset has been fitted with a two-compartment model parameterized with microconstants. For all parameters, a log normal distribution has been assumed. If I look at the diagnostic plots, the individual fits and the ops versus spread look good. But if I check the distribution of the random effects looking at the PDF, we can see a model misspecification. On this plot, the black line represents the expected theoretical normal distribution, while the blue histogram represents the empirical distribution of the individual etas. Note that to calculate the etas, I have not used the EBEs, but the samples from the conditional distribution in order to avoid bias due to shrinkage. For V, K12 and K21, the empirical distribution matches with the model assumption of normally distributed random effects. However, for K, it looks like the individual etas do not follow a normal distribution. This can be verified using a Shapiro-Wilk test. This test is done automatically in Monolix in test random effects. Here's the small p-value, highlighted in red, indicates that the empirical distribution of the random effects significantly deviates from a normal distribution. So this means that assuming a log normal distribution with this expression here and the etas following a normal distribution is not correct. What we can do instead is to assume such a distribution with the eta still following a normal distribution, but f a transformation that transforms the eta such that f of eta is a skewed distribution. One convenient transformation is the Box-Cox transformation, as proposed in this paper, which has the following formula. This transformation adds one additional parameter, lambda, that controls how much a normal distribution is distorted by the transformation. So that would be the normal distribution. If I transform it using a Box-Cox transformation with lambda equals 1, I get something like this, so that is right skewed. And on the opposite, if I take lambda equals minus 1, then the transform distribution is left skewed. If lambda tends to 0, we recover the normal distribution, and larger values of lambda lead to larger skewness. This distribution seems a good candidate for our dataset, so let's try it. To implement this distribution, I will have to separate the fixed effect k-pop from the random effect eta and reconstruct the parameter distribution in the model file. Let's see this in practice. In the structural model, let's open in the editor to have it bigger. In the input list, I have defined k-pop, the fixed effect, eta k, the random effect, and lambda that controls the Box-Cox transformation. In the code, I defined eta bar, which is a Box-Cox transformation of eta according to the formula I had on the slides. And then I defined the elimination rate k as the fixed effect k-pop times exponential eta bar, the transformed eta. In the graphical user interface, I need to remove the random effects for k-pop and lambda because these two will be the same for all individuals. For lambda, I set a normal distribution such that it can have positive or negative values depending if it's right or left skewed. And for eta k, I also set a normal distribution because eta k is now a normal distribution centered around zero with a standard deviation omega that will be estimated. So I set it to normal here, and in the initial estimates, I need to fix a value to zero. So I set a value of zero here, and then in the settings, I can set it as fixed. For lambda, I have chosen minus 1 as an initial value according to what I have seen in the previous run. Note that you cannot choose 0 as initial value because 0 is a forbidden value because in the model we divide by lambda and we cannot divide by 0. If I look at the plots, I now see that it looks much better. The distribution of the etas is much closer to normal. And according to the Shapiro-Wilk test in the results, this eta distribution does not significantly differ from a normal distribution. And the likelihood has been improved by 14 points. So that's an example of how to implement a custom parameter distribution by separating the fixed effect from the random effect. This separation makes Monex a bit less efficient in terms of speed and convergence, so do it only if necessary and choose the initial values carefully. The recipe to define the log normal distribution with Box-Cox transformation is the following. In the structural model file, you defined in the model input list param pop, eta, param, and lambda, the fixed effect, random effect, and Box-Cox transformation parameter. Then we need to define the Box-Cox transformation with the following formula. Then we define the parameter with the log normal distribution taking the transformed eta as an input. And finally, we can write in the table statement the param such that we can output it as we have done for the first example. And in the statistical model and task and initial estimate tab, we're going to remove the random effects for param pop and lambda, set a normal distribution for lambda and eta param, set an initial value for eta param as 0 and set it as fixed, and finally set a positive or negative value for lambda different from 0. You can find, as usual, more information online. Have a nice week.